Hey guys, as those of you who have been following me on Instagram know, I competed in a meet this past Saturday with Elite Powerlifting Canada. So at first I was going to make a YouTube video letting you guys know how my powerlifting competition went, what lifts I ended up hitting, all that kind of stuff. But then I realized that if you're following me on Instagram already, you already know how the meet went. It went very well. I finally hit my 500 pound deadlift that I've been chasing forever. So that was super exciting. So being at this meet, there were a few people there who it was actually their first powerlifting meet that they'd ever done. And it kind of reminded me of my first powerlifting meet that I ever did. And the firestorm of craziness that a first powerlifting meet can be, especially if you don't go into it having been to a powerlifting meet before, if you're completely new to it, it can be crazy. You don't know what to expect. So I thought I would make a video of some do's and don'ts for your first ever powerlifting meet. And of course, these do's and don'ts will apply to every powerlifting meet you ever do, but especially if it's your first one, these may be helpful to you. First do is if when you decide to do a powerlifting meet, you know that you're going to want to cut any kind of weight, start that weight cut as early as you can. This is a mistake that I made for my first meet. I knew I wanted to drop down to the 181.5 and under weight class. I had about 8 pounds to lose to get into that weight class, and I knew that I was not going to be cutting any water. We'll get to that, but for me, cutting water for my first meet just wasn't going to happen. So I thought starting a month out was a good idea. It wasn't. It probably would have taken me about 3 or 4 months to properly slowly cut that weight, and I ended up missing that weight class by like 1 pound. Whereas if I would have started much earlier, I could have taken it at a slower pace and I likely would have hit weight. If you've got 3 months, use the 3 months. If you've got 4 months, use the 4 months. It's just going to make things less stressful for you. This leads me to my first don't. Some people might not agree with me on this, but in my opinion, do not cut water for your first powerlifting meet. There's just no good reason for it. Like, if it's your first meet, then obviously you're not competing at some super high level where the weight class is going to make that big of a difference to you. I did not cut any water for my first powerlifting meet. I've cut water for meets since then, and I've learned how my body responds to that, and I've learned what. But going into a first meet when you're already nervous and you're already probably stressed out, and then to add on top of that trying to cut water, I just don't think is a good idea. Second do for your first powerlifting meet is do set realistic openers for yourself. You're likely used to doing things a certain way in the gym. Things feel great. You're not stressed. You're well rested usually probably when you're going in to do your workout. You choose the time of day that you feel the best. You use bars that you're used to. All of a sudden you're doing your first meet and everything's completely different. So the best example I can think of is like, there's going to be rack commands for the squat. There's going to be depth that you need to hit. There's going to be pauses on the bench. These are all things that even if you train for them, you can't train for the exact feeling of doing those things in the meet. So make sure when you're choosing your opener, you choose something that you can absolutely smash on any day, on a bad day. The last thing you want to do is be overambitious with your openers and then end up bombing out. And I mean, that's going to put a pretty solid damper on your first meet ever. But along with this is the don't be too hard on yourself. So if for some reason you do end up bombing out, or you miss a second attempt that you really wanted, or you miss a third attempt that you really wanted, you know, take a deep breath. It's not the end of the world. Focus on the rest of your meet and just have the best meet that you can without beating yourself up for little things that may not go perfectly. Even for me, like the second meet that I ever did, I missed my first squat attempt. I got called for depth on it. I didn't know if I should redo that weight. I didn't know if I should still move up. I was just beating myself up because I just felt like it was such a fail to miss that opener that I had purposely chosen to be easy. But you know what? When stuff like that happens, you've still got an entire meet to get through, and you need to get through it without being so hard on yourself. So my last do for your first ever powerlifting meet is do ask for help. So it's your first meet. People are going to most likely be really nice to you. Powerlifting is a sport where the community in general is super nice, super friendly. Tell people it's your first meet, ask people for help, ask them for advice, and chances are you're going to be pleasantly surprised by the kind of reaction that you get. Also helpful in this regard is if you can have someone there with you that day who can do your handling and, you know, help you warm up and all that kind of stuff, that's the best case scenario, especially for your first meet. I'm lucky, so my husband, he is my coach, so he does all my handling, he's always at my meets. Obviously, that's not going to be the case for everyone, but I mean, if you have a workout buddy, if you work out at a gym where other people do powerlifting, even if you have a friend who's interested in what you're doing and wanted to come watch anyway and is open to learning a couple things, any of these people are better than having no one there with you on that day. And don't leave your planning till the last minute. So this is a hint where things can end up getting super weird if you miss something in your bag that you need. You know, you don't want to be packing your bag the day before and then you end up being nervous and you forget your knee sleeves and you don't have them. The last meet I did before this past one, I forgot deadlift socks, and shockingly, people will maybe think you're weird if you ask them to use their dirty, sweaty socks, but I had to do it or not deadlift. So somebody lent me their socks. Not too shockingly, they didn't want their socks back after I wore them to deadlift. All of this could have been avoided if I had started packing my bag, checking it 5 times, and being super organized before going into that meet. So anyways, those are my do's and don'ts for your first powerlifting meet, and I would love to hear if you have any that I missed that you would like to add. Please comment below or comment on my Instagram and tell me about your first powerlifting meet that you ever did, and even maybe some embarrassing stories that you have. That would be even better. Okay, have a good one. What I can handle and what I can't. Thank you.